Hey everybody, let's talk a little THT. That's right, I'm talking Talen, Horton-Tucker. What a big preseason he had. He was the pleasant surprise of the preseason breakout for your Los Angeles Lakers. And we're at a point now where me saying, you know, he deserves minutes and let's figure out a way for him to get minutes on this extremely deep roster, that's not even a hot take anymore. I think we're past that point. It's only been four preseason games, but I don't think saying that Talen Horton-Tucker needs minutes is controversial at all at this point. I think it's just accepted as a fact that not only does he need minutes, but he is going to get them. In fact, his Lakers teammates are in agreement with that. This is what Anthony Davis had to say after the game against the Phoenix Suns to close out the preseason. About Talen Horton-Tucker, AD said, "I mean, he's been great from day one. Even in the bubble last year, he's been great for us, and he's a kid who wants to learn and wants to go out there and compete and be thrown in the fire. He doesn't shy away from matchups. He doesn't shy away from big moments. He listens, and that's all you can ask for a guy who is a young player. For him to come in and play with so much confidence and do good things for us on defense and on the offensive end, it's huge for us, and he's going to be a big role for us this year. He's continuing to learn this second year. He's still learning the game. The future is bright for him for sure." Okay, so a lot of praise from Anthony Davis, and he said, so he's going to have a big role for us this year. That much is evident. It's clear he has to have a big role because he frankly has been too good. Just listen to these stats. They are ridiculous for a second round pick. It was 46th overall just a little over a year ago. And in the preseason, he put up 20.5 points, 31.6 minutes average, 55% from the field, 54% from three, 90% from the line, 6.5 boards, three assists, 2.3 steals. Now, is all of that sustainable? Well, yes and no. The no part is the shooting. 55% from the field, 54% from three, 90% from the line. That suggests Talen Horton-Tucker is, frankly, the best shooter in the NBA by a mile. And I don't think that's the case. I don't think he's a bad shooter, but that's asking a bit much to say that he's that good of a shooter. So there's some regression coming there, no question. But what about the rest of it? What about the rest of his game? I actually think that is 100% sustainable. The other things we've seen Talen Horton-Tucker do, because now I know it's only four games, but we've seen him do these things, getting into the paint, scoring, defending at a high level against some of the best players in the NBA. We saw him do it against Kawhi Leonard. We saw him do it against Patrick Beverley, some of the better defenders. Javon Carter for the Phoenix Suns is a very good defender. Even stole the ball from LeBron James a number of times Friday night. Talen Horton-Tucker was able to take him to school. So THT is able to wreak havoc on a defense by getting into the paint, and that is the exact skill set that the Lakers did not have last season. It's why we were talking about the Lakers maybe trading for Derrick Rose or bringing in Deion Waiters. It was so they could find someone who could get into the paint and put pressure on the rim. And so far, THT has proven that it does not matter who is defending him. He can still do that, and he's pretty good when he gets there at kicking the ball out to open shooters, if that option is available, or finishing himself with a variety of very, very creative scoop shots at the rim. On the defensive end of the floor, he uses that ridiculous physical profile. He's 6'4", 234, with a 7'1 wingspan. So he has crazy, he's not that tall, but he has crazy long arms, which allow him to play bigger, and he's heavy. He is built. So this is a guy that can withstand some physical contact, and his super long arms allow him to defend players that are bigger than him. Look, he broke up a lob play for DeAndre Ayton in the game against the Suns. He just went up and got it because he's got these crazy pterodactyl wing arms. And then he came back down to the other end and drained a three because he's got the range to do that. He's got this incredible versatility and it allows him to be effective on either end of the floor. However, I will say, I don't think we're going to see preseason Talen Horton-Tucker during the regular season in the sense of dominating the ball. Why? Well, because LeBron James is going to be out there more. Dennis Schroeder is going to be out there more. Both of those guys missed a lot of time during the preseason for rest and due to Schroeder's ankle injury. I think they're going to wind up handling the ball a lot, but head coach Frank Vogel has talked often about how THT is just as good playing off the ball as he is on it. I do think the Lakers are going to need him on the ball. And frankly, if we're looking at just this small sample size, THT was better than Dennis Schroeder in the preseason. And if that's something that continues, maybe we do see him handling the ball more. But I think at least initially he will be playing off ball quite a bit. But again, when you can defend at a high level, that and that's something THT can do, that will get you minutes in Frank Vogel's system. That's what you have to have. The rest of it, from Frank Vogel's perspective, what he can do on the offensive end is the icing on the cake. And that's something that can really help drive the Lakers' second unit. Having somebody like him that can catch the ball and create off the bounce and wreak havoc by getting into the paint. And we've also seen that he can knock down shots from the perimeter. And according to Anthony Davis, confidence is not an issue with this young man at all. He is not afraid of the big moment. That's what we've seen from him so far. So at this point, I think it's very, very clear. Talen Horton-Tucker will be a big piece for the Lakers this season. He'll be a big part of their team moving forward. And the Lakers found a gem in the second round. All right, guys, give me your thoughts on THT. How do you see his role developing for the Lakers this season, playing alongside LeBron James, Dennis Schroeder, these other guys who can also handle the ball? Give me your thoughts in the comments down below. And don't forget, follow Lakers Nation across social media at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. And if you want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Instagram. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.